OK. Un new topic, starter and a store. OK, I will talk about starter before and the store at the end. OK, the starter is the C++ Tango device server, like any other one. It's a pure Tango device starter. No, there is nothing specific except one feature in database device. I will show you later. It has been starting to be written in 2000, like Pogo, using C++98 and the first Tango prototype. And with the first Tango prototype, there was no guideline. State and status are not attributes, no polling, no events. Attributes were not a class and so on. It was at the very beginning of Tango. All threads are omni-threads using a Tango monitor object. Few command attributes are still present for backward compatibility because I don't know if someone somewhere using these commands, I don't know. Servers are managed on different control levels. As you know, the default level number is 5 by default, but you could change it using the class property, the starter class property, NBase startup levels. At ESRF, we use 8 levels, for instance. Yes, you can see the starter in Pogo with all commands and attributes and classes. The state, as you know, well, I think you know, because it's just a reminder, is on when all servers are running, moving when one is running, but the admin device is not responding. Standby when a server is running, but the admin device does not run since a while. Alarm if there is more than one instance running, off if all the servers are stopped, and unknown if there is a problem with the start at the startup. commands start, stop, start all, dev stop all, read logs, kill server, hard kill server for using kill -9, update server info to query database to update the server list, and reset statistics when we want to reset it. Attributes, only one attribute is used by a store, except the state, of course. This is an attribute called servers, which is a string spectrum containing the server name, its state, if it's controlled or not, which control level, and if there is more one instance. Okay, this is you can see the content of this an example of the contents of this attribute spectrum. Just a small reminder: how a server registers on a host when a server starts. It writes its IOR on the database to be imported by clients, but it updates a row in a table containing the server name, the host where it is running, the control if it is controlled or not, and the startup level. This information is very useful to configure the starter at startup and when something changes on the database. At the startup phase, if this is something special, I think it's a Tango feature, but as I know, it's the starter is the only one using this this feature. It loop. If the database server is not running, it loops until the database server is started. Okay, it gets the server list registered for the specified host containing the controlled information using this command. It built a vector of controlled server objects containing, of course, this information. And it starts if there is a class property defined if it needs to start all servers at the startup, and if it's true, it starts a server. It starts all servers through a dedicated thread. Okay, we will see later how it works. Okay, the fork phase, because the fork phase is used here, and when the dev start on the server is received, it forks the server. It forks a server with a list of server to with a server or a list of server to start. The thread will fork the server, wait to find it in the / proc directory under Linux to have ID and command line to know if it is running. It wait a bit, and when it has been started, it wait a bit and it can start the next one. The update server info is a special, very special command. It is not a special command, but it is used very in a very special way, you can see. Because we need to update this server info when a new server is registered on the host. When a new server registered on the host start on another host, and when a control level change for this server. But if all starters are polling the database server to know if something has changed, it will be very heavy, and the database server will be overloaded. It's very because, for instance, at TSRF we have more than 300 servers running on the machine control system. If all starters are calling database to every second to know if something has changed, it will be a mess. Okay, to avoid this problem, this is done inside the database server itself. If the number 2, 3, or 4 are true, a little thread in the database device itself is activated to execute this update server info on the starter on the starter, where a new one has been started, a new server has been started, or a new server has been started, have stopped to run on this one and started on another one, because it manage one or two starter at when something change in the database. Okay, for instance, the previous host and the new host this little thread, and this little thread do a device proxy on the expected starter to send this command. It's very it exists I think from 2003, I think it's at the very beginning of Tango. It has been implemented, and there is no problem using this way. But it could be useful for a new starter programmer to know it is called by the starter by the database server itself. By convention, the starter device name is Tango admin and the host name, without FQDN, of course. But for at ESRF, when we rebuilt our database for the new accelerator, we decided to change the domain name to SIS, as you know, the well-known SIS database one, for instance. And to change it, I create a starter class property, which is a domain. And now we can have a SIS admin. The family name did not change. And if this class property is set, the starter name can be changed. How the server control is done? As I said, it is a dedicated thread. Who knows the list of the process to be controlled? You read in a slash proc directory on Linux, and with a Windows system call, it get PID and command line. It will parse the command line to know the name, of course, the server name, but for instance, for Java or Python, you can start for Java, this is Java, sometimes minus D parameter and so on, and the class will come later, and this is a pure parsing on the command line to know if the server is inside this process list. If the process is not found, of course the process object is set fault. If the process is found, now the admin device will be pinged. If it is done by an there is a thread to ping for each server, for each controlled server. if ping failed, the process is set moving, and if ping answer, the process is set on. Okay, this is the main thread, the main starter thread, so well known like any device server. A thread is started with a list of process to control inside the slash proc directory, and a ping thread for each server to control. If the device is not set fault by this thread, the ping thread try to ping the device admin and the admin device, and the server object will have the new state moving or on. Okay, the source files, class factory, any class factory and starter state machine, like any other server, the starter CPP, the starter class, the starter util, there is the ping thread, .cpp and .h, the check process util, this is which one you looking a process in a slash proc information, and start the process thread. And there is a special file for Windows if we want to compile it as a service or not. Okay, you can find it on GitHub, maybe in GitLab in the future. Okay, now we can talk about Astor. Astor is the name Astor is a reference to Astor Piazzolla, a famous tango player. It's a Java GUI managing all starters find in the control system, in the specified control system. It has been started to be written as the other tools in 2000 using Java 1.2, the first swing Java release, and first Tango prototype with a very poor Tango Java API, very poor data device server, no guidelines, no events, and so on. And it has been modified with compatibility since 20 years. It is a frame displaying a tree, but it's generally, it's just an introduction. You know that the Tango data, you can see the Tango database inside the tree, the Tango access control if it has been activated, and it put host in branches. A new dialog window can be opened on each host to know the server's states. Astor is a server-oriented tool. It is not a device-oriented. Jive is a device-oriented, but do not forget Astor is a server-oriented. When a server is green, means it is running, and admin device is responding. It does not mean the device are on, because some people make the mistake. Okay, there is some parameter at startup, minus RW for or no parameter for so read write, minus DB in RO for read write. Astor is read write, but the database is read only, and minus RO for read only. At startup, it gets the database list of starters registered in the control system. For each device name, the member is the host name. A thread is started for each host to manage the states. It subscribes to start, yes, for since I think since since Tango 9, I think it subscribes for to starter state attributes, and the main thread gets a host collection, which is a starter device property, but it's to do not overload the database server. It doesn't take the database server is also a device oriented. Is device oriented. When you want, if I want the property of all starters, of all starter devices, I have to do many calls on database. To have only one, I use a very special call on database server with a direct MySQL select to get it in one call. It does same thing to go host usage to put on command on the tree. Then the branches are sorted by alphabetic order because alphabetic is has been chosen as default order. But there is a free property, Astor last collections, to put some branches at the end of the tree, and it could be useful for host in maintenance or in the labs, or I don't know. It is seen in control system, but it could be not really controlled. Okay, I think you know this meaning of bubble on the main tree and on the server window. Yes, I think you know it. You are not Tango debutant. How to configure Astor? You can configure the default value for your host tree window dimension, your host panel dimension, because it depends some small control system could need a small window, but a big control system could need big windows. For host panel, this is the default dimension. If it could be the size could be changed by the mouse, but if it's larger, if it needs a larger window, it had scroll bars. Yeah. Yes. Okay. You can set Jive in read only mode. You can put a command for using for remote login feature. The default user on this remote login on SSH. There is I don't know if you know this this feature. This is the default. The default feature is okay. It's true. When a starter starts, it starts all devices, all start servers registered on the host. But for instance, when you have a power cut on your crate, if when the power is back, if all hosts are rebooting, if all starters are in startup phase, if all starters start all servers, the database starter will be overloaded, could be overloaded. But at ESRF, when we stop the control servers before rebooting all crates, we put it false, in false, and we restart all hosts and all starters, and then we start it again smoothly. For instance, the vacuum part, then the RF part, then the insertion device part, and so on. you can disable this access on this preference if you start a store with this parameter. Okay, there is you can add on the help menu. You can help you can add help pages, for instance, the Tango control pages, your own documentation, your wiki, or so on. This is ESRF one. This is a free property. This is the syntax, and you can add it by clicking on this button. But you can do it with Jive. It's easy to do it. Okay, I talk about this. There is a pool. As you know, in a server there is only one pool. There is one pool of pooling. This is a default management. You can in Tango you can have several pools of pooling, and in Astor you have a tool to manage it by drag and drop to pick to pick a device because you can pick a device and put it in a, for instance, this one, and put it in another thread to tune your server to avoid an erratic behavior. There is a server statistic because when a server is started and stopped, the starter put it in a file, and Astor can display the statistic on a host and by server. There is a starter class property called auto restart duration in minutes. At TSF, we use 2 hours. If a server has been running more than 2 hours, it will be restarted automatically if it died by another way than the dev kill on the starter. It could be useful for buggy server, but we put a minimum time to be running because we don't want to restart it every 5 seconds the same server. And there is a reset on statistic, but it is protected by a password. I'm sorry, don't remember the password. I think it's a Super Tango, but I think if you start Astor with export super underscore tango is equal true, there is no password to reset the statistics. Okay, this is the statistic, and you can see here the server died one time after 48 minutes, and it didn't start automatically, but on a request by the operator. But this one runs. The second time it has been restarted automatically by the starter itself. Okay, this is an overview of all the features we can find in Astor. You can see Jive, you can see ATK monitor, ATK panel, an event tester, the log viewer, the thread pool manager, and you can see this overview. Okay, I think if you have questions, you are welcome.
So I think there are some questions on the chat. Some of them are related to Astor and some of them to the starter. So there was one related to the starter. why unknown and not fault if there are problems on startup?
No, no, so if there is problem on there is problem on startup, it's only no database or something like this. It's not if the problem cannot read the this is really because fault is there is at least one server not running. If it's the unknown, the problem is more important. There is this is a starter problem. It is not a server problem. That's why it could be changed, but the decision has been taken because it is not a server problem. It is a control server problem. It is a starter problem.
And there was a question from Sergi. When writing scripts to launch Python device servers from starter, is it better to call directly or in background? So adding the commercial end to the command in the script.
For Python, and it's the same for Java because it's launched through a script. All processes are forked like in CPP in a dedicated thread, and normally with a commercial signal it's, or without, I think it's the same because when a starter starts a server, he forgets a link on it to for the server continue to run if the starter is stopped. And he cut all linked on it with or without this special character.
Which means that if the starter is dying, the devices is which were started with the starter, they are still running, right?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes, I think you... Everybody, I'm not sure, but I thought everybody has have seen if starter is killed, all servers are still running. Because normally now there is no problem, but some time ago, a long time ago, there was bug. Not inside starter because starter is perfect, but inside Tango library. And sometimes, no, I'm joking, but there was bugs sometimes on starter or in Tango library, and starter died. But of course, server were still running.
Okay, there were some questions from ZB. How to start Tango DS with specific ORB endpoint using starter?
Like in Python, through
a script.
A script, yes. Yeah, maybe we can in the future. It could be. I think it could be a new feature to implement to have parameters like ORB parameter to. A feature, but until today, it does not exist.
Okay. Another question from ZB. Is it possible to start other processes like an intermediate service to control the hardware? For instance, detectors server process?
I think without modification, it's difficult because as I explained, the startup phase is it started, and there is a ping on the admin device, but I think there is no admin device on this on the tool.
This tool. So they could be started by the script.
Yes.
Potentially.
But then there wouldn't be any monitoring
of the.
It's not a problem, but not directly because to start it you need to have it registered in Tango database. And the second problem is what will be pinged. Mm-hmm. But if you start it in a script with a device, there is no problem.
Mm-hmm. And so he was saying, is it planned to add these functionalities? Well.
Not me, but
we can discuss that. Yeah,
you're welcome.
Okay, that's an interesting question as well. Still from ZB, how to properly enable different environments for running device servers? For instance, Python virtual environment, Conda environment. Is it possible to define a hook to execute before the Tango device server starts? Because right now the environment is the same as the environment of the starter.
Yes, if you do not start it through a script, there is no way. But yes, it could be a feature. But everybody is welcome.
And last question from ZB, more a question about the future. There exist other tools with similar functionalities, maybe not so Tango oriented. For instance, Circus Supervisor, and of course the whole Kubernetes world. What is the future plan? retirement for you.
I am not really concerned. I have no idea about an answer to this question, but maybe someone else.
Question from Xavier, I think. What are the missing features, if any?
It's not to me to answer.
Okay, well, this is something that can be discussed in any case on the...
Yes, this is on the discussion with everybody.
If some people have some ideas for new features or things like that, you can create an issue on the different Git repositories or on Tango Ticket repository. On GitHub, and these features can be discussed there, and you can also propose some pull requests if you feel you want to implement them. And then there was another question from Sergi regarding the auto restart duration.
Yeah.
Is auto restart enabled just by setting a value to this property?
Yes. Yes, because if this property does not exist, nothing is done. If this property is set to a time when a device died, not stopped by starter. If it is a starter which stops the server, there is no. It's like. There is no auto restart, of course, but if it is killed by a kill minus nine or by a core dump, if it has run, it has been running more than this specified time, Hey, you know why this property exists, Reynald? Do you remember a very well known
some famous device servers which were dying very often? Yes,
dying very very often, and we were fed up to restart it so, too often.
Okay, is there any other question? It seems not.
1 hour and a half, no.
Very good. So if not, I think we can close this session. And the next kernel webinar will be on the 20th of January. I think it's a Wednesday as well. And it will be at 10 o'clock Paris time, so Central European time. And it will be about CPP Tango and the events. And it will be presented by Emmanuel Torel. And we will try to upload the video of all the kernel meetings on the web, and we will advertise the link on the Tango mailing list. So thank you for joining, and have a great day. Have a very nice day.
Goodbye, everybody.